The Big Baloney, QE2 and Pope Francis, My Humble Suggestion. June 2, 2019 by Anna Von Reitz. This morning I was treated to a parody news story from newspunch.com, announcing that Queen Elizabeth is claiming to be the 43rd great-granddaughter of the Prophet Mohammed. She is, according to their story, trying to convince the Muslim world that she is their rightful ruler, as part of a bid to usher in global crown rule and perk up the oil business. It's bizarre enough to be true, not the claim to be the Prophet's progeny, the news story, and it would neatly explain the proliferation of guillotines in America and the forced migration of Muslim people and the accompanying demands for Sharia law. The actual truth is that Queen Elizabeth is a criminal, a proven criminal, and she needs to be arrested. If her own people won't do it, someone else will have to. And that will mean another bloody, senseless world war. As a German by actual lineage, Elizabeth has about as much right to the throne of Great Britain as I do. I might have a little more claim than she does, because I have some Scottish Clan MacDonald blood flowing in my veins. So there is strike one. She isn't a Windsor, that's just an otherwise honorable name adopted because it slyly admits that she is the prince of the heir's purser. She occupies the same basic position as the French Pacer family, Windsor, like Pacer. She's a military banker. So there's strike two, lying about her name and actual function. And then there's the actual proof of criminality and breach of trust. In 2011 she was convicted of, 1, not having been actually seated on the throne and, 2, breaking her coronation oath, by a British jury. http://mtrial.org http://jamesfetzer.blogspot.com http://terrorone2.co.uk/2011/05/12/moadab-acquitted/ http://jforjustice.co.uk/77/. This is the John Anthony Hill, JA, case. She was tried. She was convicted by a jury in a British court. Fair and square. There you have strike three. There can be no doubt that Queen Elizabeth II is in fact impersonating the Queen of Britain and has been doing so for many years. If you could do that, why not claim to be the 43rd great-granddaughter of the Prophet Muhammad? Interestingly, not only is Elizabeth impersonating the Queen of Great Britain, the substance of all her crimes against us and against many other people, is a form of impersonation, too. Enfranchisement is a form of impersonation. You take a living man and you redefine him as a franchise corporation, a thing. When goaded to arrest her, the excuses and howling from Parliament and the Privy Council amount to, but, if we did that, all the laws bearing her signature would be invalid, if we did that, there would be no lawful succession, there isn't anyway, but so what, if we did that? And then there's, but she is so old, why not just let nature take its course? Not cause any disruption of the government. Given her family history, she could last another 15 years and hope to convince us all that she's Muhammad's 43rd great-granddaughter. And go on signing invalid legislation affecting all her phony franchises the whole while. It appears that the British Parliament is afflicted with the same mental illness and dearth of common sense that afflicts the US Congress. They know that no law or treaty she has ever signed has any validity. They know that she is not actually the Queen and that any contract or covenant she had with the British people was severed within 3 days after her coronation. They've all known that for eight years, full on, in their faces, undeniable. I guess they hope that the rest of us won't notice, but we have. If the Queen isn't the Queen, there is no valid power of enforcement behind the British courts, including the British territorial courts. Quite simply, they have no lawful or legal authority to say or do jack diddly. They are all caught in a nasty double bind. If they go backward and reinstate the land law, which is what they should do, they will all be condemned to death under it. Yet there has to be some kind of law or society will devolve into chaos. Enter Sharia. But even an idiot knows that isn't going to wash. Every idiot, that is, but those in the British Parliament and Nancy Pelosi. And while we are on that topic, the Queen isn't the Queen, and the Pope isn't the Pope, either. Francis is a Jesuit. Jesuits take a lifetime vow to serve the Pope. So it follows that a Jesuit can never be the Pope. Even a Lutheran knows that. So what is going on? Every Pope since the first Pope has worn two hats. He wears the sacred office of the Pope and the secular office of the Roman Pontiff. All this was inherited at the Council of Nicaea from the Roman Emperor, Constantine, and consolidated in 800 AD under Charlemagne. So Benedict XVI, feeling himself too old to deal with the rigors of the secular office, turned to his loyal foot soldiers, the Jesuits, and chose one to take on the job of Roman Pontiff, while he, himself, openly retained the ministerial office. In other words, Benedict XVI, Pope Emeritus, is still the Pope. Francis is serving him as a loyal Jesuit, doing what he is told to do, which is basically to circle the wagons to protect the church's interests and act as Pope while taking on the burden of the secular office. So he is impersonating the Pope just as Elizabeth is impersonating the Queen. We are dealing with magicians, con men, and bad actors. This is the evil in high places the Bible speaks of, and it is essentially the sin of Moses coming home to roost. The true God gave us 10 commandments, knowing that we are too stupid and undisciplined to obey even 10 laws, but at least we could give it a good faith effort. Moses and his feckless brother, Aaron, gave the people over 600 additional laws, the equivalent of statutory laws, guaranteeing that all would be condemned. So, here we are, between the rock and the hard place, and here is my humble suggestion. 1. Forget about trying to implement Sharia law. 2. Set aside enforcement of all statutory laws. 3. Adopt the law of the kingdom of heaven. There are only three laws in heaven, and those allow everyone to save their skins. 4. Turn over the purloined property assets to me, I am the fiduciary. I will return the land and soil to the peoples of the earth without further ado. 5. Agree to the establishment of a true currency based on the value of all traded commodities and labor. A lot of lawyers will be out of work, but that is a small price to pay, especially as this is the only way that everyone keeps breathing.